Hi everyone, I'm Krista Seiden, Analytics Advocate at Google, and today I'm joined by Rotimi Izidu, who is a Product Manager on Google Optimize. In this quick tip video, Rotimi is going to walk us how to get ready for your first experiment in Optimize Free, or really how to set up your container and your account to get ready for that experiment. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and hand it over to Rotimi.
Awesome. Thank you, Krista. Once you initially get access to Google Optimize, you will be in the Google Optimize Accounts page. While you're there, you have the option to view the accounts that you have, as well as any containers that are part of those accounts. Google Optimize automatically creates for you a default account called My Account, as well as a default container named My Container. From this view, you can actually edit the account details of that default account, as well as any other container information. With that said, most of your work will be done within the container. So let's go through and check out what's in My Container. Once you access the container view, you're presented with this handy checklist to the right. This provides for you the sequence of steps that you need to complete in order to be able to create experiments in Google Optimize. The first step is to link to a Google Analytics property. So go ahead and click on the Link Property button. Once you do so, Google Optimize automatically pulls in all of the GA properties that you have access to. In this case, I only have access to my sample website. Once that is completed, you need to select at least one view. Note that Google Optimize uses these views to collect goals, objectives, and other useful metrics during the experiment. So we'll go ahead and link to our GA property. Once that step is completed, you get a prompt asking to add the Optimize snippet to your site. The Optimize snippet is what actually runs your experiments and creates the various variations for your customers to try out. So we click on the Get Snippet button and you're presented with the Optimize Analytics snippet. This is actually a very simple process and only requires that you copy one line of code from here. In this case, that is the one outline that is bolded, and you need to then place it in your GA tracking code. So I have some sample GA tracking code set up here, and you will just need to add that line that was bolded previously at this point. Additionally, it is also recommended that you add the page hiding snippet. The page hiding snippet basically helps to minimize any flickering that could occur as the variations are being created for your customers. To do so, simply copy this snippet of code below here and add that as early in your head tag as possible. This is not mandatory, but it's definitely recommended to get the best experience with Google Optimize. Alternatively, you can install the Google Optimize snippets using the Google Tag Manager. To do so, please follow the instructions outlined in the Help Center article on deploying Optimize with Tag Manager. Now that we have installed the Optimize snippet, we are actually ready to go. Please note that the Install Optimize Snippet step will not be automatically checked, as it is something that you need to validate on your own.
Great. Thanks, Rotimi. That was a really good overview of how you can really quickly get set up to start your first experiment in Google Optimize.
Thank you, Krista.